how to make this super cute bat using only Stampin' Up! Punches, and how to make the cute little quick chocolate bar wrapper to go with it. Thanks! Let's get started then in making Mr. Bat. So to make the bat, what we're going to use is a 1 3/8 circle punch, and this is going to be the bat's head, a 1 1/4 inch circle punch, and this is going to be the bat's body. I used our small star punch, and I just cut off 2 of the prongs of the star to make his fangs. I have the 1/2 inch circle punch, and these are going to be the bat's eyeballs. The 1/4 inch circle punch to be the blacks of the eyes. I'll show you how we're going to make the wings, but I used the 1 3/4 inch circle punch and then the slot punch to make the scalloped edges. And then the bat's ears are just made with the 5-point flower punch, and I just cut off the petals to make the bat's ears. So let me start by showing you how I'm going to make the wings. And to do that, I have my 1 3/4 inch circle punch. I take my slot punch, and then I'm just going to punch, I say that word an awful lot, across the wing using the scallop. And when you get to the other side, you've got your scrap piece, and you now have your wing. So super quick, super cute, super easy. Now, to assemble our bat, just use a 2-way glue pen from Stampin' Up. They're fantastic. I'm going to start with the head. I'm just going to color on some glue, and I'm going to glue on our body. Again, the body is the smaller of the two circles. Now I'm going to attach my wings. So to attach my wings, I'm just going to color on a bit of the glue here on the edges. Line these 2 wings up how I like them to lay. And just set my body right on top of my bat. Give it a little press. And then, of course, the eyeballs, just color on your glue. And I'm gonna stick my 1/2 inch circles for the eyes on Mr. Batty. I'd like to cheat, I just do my glue right on the face. I'm gonna glue on my fangs. Apologize for my fingers in the way there. Glue on my fangs. I like them touching. There you go. Color where my blacks and my eyes are gonna go. Stick those on, and then I'm going to just flip them over, and I'll apply a little bit of glue here where the ears will go, and you can see how quick and easy Mr. Batty comes together. Now the trick about 2-way glue, let it sit aside for a few minutes just to firm up and make sure that the glue sets, but really, really, really quickly you can see how I have my bat. And now I'll show you how I just assembled my chocolate bar wrapper. I took a 5 inch by 6 inch piece of basic gray cardstock. I have my chocolate bar. And now I'm just gonna actually wrap this around the chocolate bar. And I've applied adhesive on the ends of my paper because I'd like my chocolate bar just to be able to slide out. So I've wrapped my chocolate bar. I'll stick on a strip of purple paper here, the lavender lace. I've got my greeting that will be covered a little bit by the knot in my ribbon, and Mr. Batty will go here, but before that I'm just going to tie on my ribbon just to make sure my bat will stick. And to do that, I'll show you my ribbon trick. I always keep all of my ends flat, so I've kept my ends flat. The top piece of ribbon gets folded underneath the bottom, and then I pull in the opposite direction where my ribbon was. And then again, keeping your ends flat so they don't fold on top of each other. The top piece slides underneath. And then when I pull my ribbon out, my ends are gonna wanna go the same direction as the ribbon. And you can see really, really quickly how I can put this chocolate bar candy wrapper together using the super cute Mr. Batty made all with punches. Thanks for joining me today, and I can't wait to hear about the creations you make. Have a great day.